Sometimes we find our files infected with a computer virus. In this tutorial, we will get introduced to the concept of a virus by writing a simple one in Python. First thing first, let's get introduced to the definition of a computer virus. A virus is a typical malware program that infects a particular type of file, or most files, by injecting data or code. It tries to list files in all directories and then inject typical data or code into those files. The point to be noted, a virus does not replicate itself. It just continuously infects all files in the directory/folders. The malware that replicates itself and consumes hard disk space is typically called a worm. You can refer to our hashnode article for a better understanding and a step-by-step guide of the same. Let's start coding. To write a simple virus, we will use the following modules. Here, module OS is the most important one as it will help us to list all the files along with the absolute path. An absolute path starts with the root directory slash. It is necessary here, as while working with numerous files you must know the exact location. We will use pathlib to retrieve the extension of a file. It can be done in multiple ways though, so you may not find this module necessary at all. Daytime and time are used only for the start time of execution. If you want the script to start working right now, you may not need these modules as well. Let's start creating a virus class that accepts 4 arguments when it is called. Here, the infect_string will be used to insert a file. If the user does not provide input, it will use the default value. By default, the path is set to be the root directory slash. From here, it will browse all subdirectories and files. However, the user can provide a target path as well. Users can define target file extensions. If not, the default is set to be python_files.py. The user can also provide the target_file_list that contains all the listed target files. If none, the constructor method set it as an empty list. Now we will create another method named list_files that lists all files within directories and subdirectories given an initial path. Here, in the method we did the followings. 1. List all files in the current working directory. 2. Iterate over all files and only consider visible files. Avoid hidden files. Example, starts with the dot. In Unix-based systems. 3. Get the absolute path using os.path.join. 4. Retrieve the file extension using pathlib. 5. Check if it is a directory using os.path.isdir. If yes, call the same function and pass the path to continue digging deeper. In the coding world, it is called a recursive function. 7. Check if the extension matches with the target extension. If yes, check whether it is already infected by looking for the string in the file. If the string is not found, append it to the list. Now we will add another method that can infect the string in the given file name. To prepend the self.infect_string, we first read the whole file and keep the contents in a variable data. Then add our string before the data and write to the file. Point to be noted, in this example as we are using Python files, we need to exclude our own file, right? That's why I exclude the file name there in the very first condition. The final method integrates everything. If you want to set a timer, example, 60 seconds, then provide input to the timer while calling this method. If you want to set a date, example, someone's birthday, then provide input to the target_date while calling this method. And then our primary mission begins. First, list all target files by calling the list_files method. Then for each file, insert the string using the infect method. Now, let's create our main function and run the code. Here, we first create an object of the class. And then call the start_virus_infections method with providing a timer or a date. To avoid hassle, use os.path.abs_path, which refers to the current directory only, so that you do not get hurt with inserting the string in other necessary Python codes you wrote before. To have an easier testing environment, create a few Python files in the same directory and check if your virus is able to insert the string to those files. So this was it guys, I hope this tutorial was really helpful, and if it was, then consider subscribing and hit that like button below. I will meet you in the next tutorial. Until then, keep coding.